Let us learn about poetic devices today. Poetic devices are also called literary devices or figures of speech. A poetic or a literary device is a technique a writer uses to produce a special effect in the writing. A piece of writing can really shine through with the use of various poetic devices. Six poetic devices you must know. The first one is simile. A simile is a direct comparison of two unlike things using the words like or as. In simple words, a simile is a comparison between two things. But do not forget to use the words like or as. For example, Roma is as sweet as honey. My brother is brave like a lion. Here, Roma is compared to honey and there is usage of the word as. And in the second example, brother is compared to a lion and there is usage of the word like. Hence, it is an example of simile. Dear students, simile has a brother metaphor. Metaphor is also a comparison between two things, but we do not use the words like or as. Let's see an example. The snow is a white blanket. John is a shining star. Here, we have compared snow to a white blanket and John to a shining star, but we haven't used the words like or as, yet we have made a comparison, hence it is a metaphor. Let's move to another poetic device, alliteration. Dear students, in simple words, if I have to explain alliteration to you, I would say that in a sentence, if twice or more than two times consonant sound words are there, then that sentence becomes an example of alliteration. A, E, I, O, U are vowels in English language and all other alphabets are consonants. But make sure you have to check the sound and not the alphabet. Let's see few examples. She sells seashells at the seashore. Bina Bhatt blew big bubbles. Children enjoy this poetic device because they are like tongue twisters and everybody loves speaking tongue twisters. Also, dear students, tongue twisters really help you improve the fluency of your language. Coming back to the examples, if you observe in both the examples, there are consonant sounds used more than two times. Hence, it is alliteration. Let's move on to the other poetic device, personification. Dear students, when we give human traits, qualities or characteristics to non-living things, objects, animals or abstract ideas, it is personification. For example, Tom heard the last piece of pie calling his name. The alarm clock yelled at me in the morning. Here, how can an alarm clock yell, that is shout, or how can Tom hear the pie speaking to him? So in this case, non-living things, inanimate objects, animals or abstract ideas have been given human traits, thus it is an example of personification. Let's see another poetic device, onomatopoeia, words that sound like their meanings. In other words, words that exactly sound like their own sounds are onomatopoeic in nature. For example, boom, buzz, shh, knock, knock. So all these words themselves are producing a sound. That means they are onomatopoeic in nature. There are many examples of onomatopoeia like you can see in the picture as well. Let's move on to the other one. Hyperbole. When you use exaggeration to explain something, it is usage of hyperbole. For example, the boy weighs a ton. She was so hungry, she ate the entire kitchen. That's not possible, isn't it? Hence, when you exaggerate something to explain your idea, it means you are using hyperbole. So, dear students, these were six most commonly used poetic devices and I am sure you enjoyed learning about the same. They are very simple and would really add a lot of spark and shine to your piece of writing. Thank you. Take care.